Hi all, and welcome to this second video of the module, in which we will talk about how to use the RDF extension of OpenRefine to carry out the linking process of our dataset. Recalling the previous example in which we introduced that our goal is, in this case, to link information from the city of Linz, from the open data portal of the city of Linz, to the DVpedia datasets, using OpenRefine for that. So in OpenRefine, using the RDF extension, the first thing that we have to do is to add what is called a reconciliation service, as we see here. We distinguish two main types of reconciliation service. On the one hand, we have the ones based on Sparkle, that is, that execute Sparkle queries against a Sparkle endpoint. And as well, we can use a local file containing RDF tuples. In both cases, we will define a name for the service. We will introduce the properties. In the Sparkle endpoint case, we will introduce the Sparkle endpoint itself. If we want to query a specific graph of the dataset, we introduce the URI of that graph. And we can also specify the type of server that it is running, which has to do only with performance issues. Finally, we will select which properties we want to use to find the matches. That is, which properties of the description we want to use in our dataset and in the target dataset to compare the results. So we have properties such as RDF level or SCSI preference, pref level, sorry, or DC terms title. On the case of file-based reconciliation service, we have to introduce the file itself, the path on our computer that contains these tuples in a file, and again, the properties, the description properties, such as RDF level or DC terms, that we want to use to carry out the matching process. So let's see how can we, for example, reconcile values from a given column. In this column, in the column address 4, we have values of our dataset. In this case, all the values are the same. We have the city of Leeds, the name of the city of Leeds. So we can start reconciling this column. We are selecting here that we want to do it with a reconciliation service named DVpedia, which is a Sparkle-based reconciliation service. And as we see here, we can select the classes that we want to use, that we want to explore for finding a match. So what it is going to do is to select individuals belonging to these classes and try to find a match. We have to be careful when deciding which classes to use in this process, because depending on which one we select and which one we exclude, we will get better or worse results. So we can even try to run the reconciliation service without specifying any class. But that's really problematic when working with data sets such as DVpedia, for example, which contains hundreds of classes and thousands of individuals. If we do not filter based on a class, either from the list that it provides or specifying our own custom one, the query and the reconciliation service is going to take a long, long time. So we have to be careful when deciding which classes to select, which was the first step of the linking process, as we saw on the previous video. So once we have found the matches, we can specify which individual to select as a match. For example, if we have Bradford here and we have run our reconciliation service, we could select that for all the cells with this value, we want to obtain, or we want to select from the obtained results, for example, Bradford High School or Bradford as a city from the DVpedia dataset. Or we can select it only for this cell. So we can specify, once we obtain our results, which ones we want to use. So to see which are the values that we have obtained out of our reconciliation service, for example, from the city of Leeds, as we did before, we can select in here, edit column, add a column based on this column, which will generate a new column with the reconciliation results. In here, we can edit the expression saying cell.recon.match.id, where cell denotes the value of the cell itself, the cell within a column, that is the column we are matching. Recon is the reconciliation service, an object representing the reconciliation service. Match is the match that it has found. It can be null if we haven't found a match for a given value. An ID is the URI of the resource. As we saw before on the RDF module, everything on the semantic web and the link data world uses URIs as identifiers. So we are getting here the URI. What we see here is that for the column leads, that is the value we had in our column in here, we are getting a new column with the results of the reconciliation, which are the URIs from the Wikipedia. So it is dbpedia.org/resort/leads. And we are calling this new column that we are generating a schema place, so as to identify it and refer it later. So once we have this new column with the values of the reconciliation service, we can add on our RDF skeleton. We go to the RDF skeleton part of the RDF extension. We can add for our resources a new property. So we say add new property and we use all same as. And for the value of this all same as, what we get is the schema place value from the column schema place that we defined on the example on our previous slide in here. With that, what we get when we generate our RDF as part of the generation process of OpenRefine is that we will see how for each individual, in this case for the city of Leeds, this is our individual on our data sets, which is of type schema place, we will have an all same as property linking it to the resource in DBpedia representing the same entity, the city of Leeds in this case. With this, we will have access to the resource in DBpedia, either through an Sparkle query or when we explore our data set, having access to all the information that we saw before. This is the value of the linking process. With this, we conclude the data linking module of this course. There are many potential uses of links when working with link data. Always keep in mind that if your data is isolated, its value decreases. It is not link data. When proper links are identified, your data set becomes more findable, useful, and it attracts more users and more and allows to build more complex and useful applications. Thank you.